Right, Health and Human Services Secretary nominee Javier Becerra was before the Senate Finance Committee today. And I'll tell you what, he has a lot of ground to make up, but our next guest gave him an opportunity to, well, set the record straight on just how extreme he might be on the issue of abortion. Listen to this.
Could you name one abortion restriction that you might support?
Senator, let me try to respond this way. I have tried to make sure on this important issue for so many people, where oftentimes, again, we have different views, but deeply held views, that I have tried to make sure that I am abiding by the law. Because whether it's a particular restriction or whether it's the whole idea of abortion, whether we agree or not, we have to come to some conclusion, and that's where the law gives us.
But is there, just to be clear, is there any line you would draw? Is there just one restriction as it relates to abortion might support?
That question was asked by U.S. Senator Steve Daines of Montana, and he joins us now. Senator, welcome back to Washington Watch.
Good to join you, Tony.
Well, Senator, did you get a question? Did you get an answer to your question?
I didn't. You know, I went on just to ask him some very straightforward questions. What about a ban on the lethal discrimination of babies diagnosed with Down syndrome? Would you draw a line there? What about a ban on sex selective abortion, whether it's a little girl or a little boy? Yes or no? What about a ban on partial birth abortion? What about a ban on denials of care to survivors of botched abortions? Tony oppressed him on each one of those, trying to give him at least a chance to set the record straight, which he dodged the questions when he was before the Senate yesterday. And clearly you saw the answer, didn't get an answer there. And he's been truly, I think, one of the most radical, aggressive, pro-abortion leaders we've seen in this country when he served as Attorney General of California.
Right. And yesterday and today, his fallback was, I will enforce the law. I will abide by the law. But will he? I mean, now, that might be easy to say in California, where all of the laws were against pro-lifers, against the sanctity of human life. My bigger question, Senator, is will he abide by the Constitution, not some laws that trample upon the Constitution?
Well, as we know, this God-given right of the right to life is very clearly enumerated in our Declaration of Independence. And without the right to life, you cannot pursue happiness and liberty. And so the bottom line is he's already demonstrated the fact he's thumbed his nose at the law by what happened when we then had Secretary Azar under the Trump administration in HHS. You know, he fined California $200 million because they were in violation of federal law. And that, so whether it is abortion or religious liberty, keep in mind, Becerra has been terrible on the issue of conscience with Little Sisters of the Poor, as well as an additional mission group where he has absolutely been aggressive. In fact, it was so bad in California that they put in place a provision that if you had a crisis pregnancy center, a center taking care of these maybe scared moms who are pregnant, they required signs be put up indicating where the nearest location to get an abortion was as these young women walked into these pro-life clinics.
Yeah, and by the way, just to remind our listeners, Senator Daines, that case went all the way to the Supreme Court. Initially, it was head up by now Vice President Kamala Harris, who preceded Mr. Becerra. And he went all the way to the Supreme Court. And this is my point in terms of him enforcing the law. But he was slapped down by the Supreme Court for violating the Constitution and free speech.
He was. The Supreme Court was very clear on that. And thank God for the court ruling on this case.
So, Senator, before we move on to some of these other radical nominees, where do you think your colleagues stand with Javier Becerra as heading up the agency with the largest federal budget of any of the agencies? They oversee about 27 different institutes and sub-agencies. And as you've rightly pointed out in your questioning, they drive the policy as it pertains to the issue of the sanctity of human life.
Well, I know where I'm at. I'll be vigorously opposing him, Tony. The sad fact, I had a chat, a great conversation with former Secretary Azar, and he was telling me that about all the lawsuits of, you know, Azar versus Becerra, because the Secretary of HHS then under the Trump administration was holding California accountable. And he said, I probably have 100 lawsuits against Becerra. He said, I can't imagine here's somebody who could be the next secretary. Will it be what, a Becerra versus Becerra now in terms of the lawsuits that are out there?
Right.
So this, I'm concerned, Tony. I know where I'm at on this. I know some of my colleagues here who hold firm the convictions of life and religious liberty, and there are many of us. You know, the question is, will there be enough to get to 51, because with these nominations, the magic number is 51, given that Kamala Harris gets to cast a tiebreaker in this 50-50 Senate. I don't know if we're there yet, Tony, but we're not going to give up the fight.
Senator, this is not just someone, and we expect, you know, the change of ideologies when there's a change of jerseys. All right, so we fully anticipated that the, you know, the Democratic Party that's in the tank for abortion would have a pro-abortion attorney general, pro-abortion secretary of state, pro. I mean, it's a litmus test for the left. But this guy's not just pro-abortion. He's not just anti-life. This guy is rabid. I mean, he has a long history on this issue.
Well, he does, Tony, and if you kind of want to expand his radical views, it's clear what his positions have been as it relates to abortion, but I'm really concerned about the positions on religious liberty.
Yeah.
He has been absolutely rabid and activist, and that is very concerning as we're seeing what's happening before our very eyes in our country, where the far left is doing all they can to, you know, to cancel any right-of-center thought, religious thought. Here is one more advocate on that cancel culture bandwagon that unfortunately now seems to really characterize what's going on in the Biden administration.
Duly noted. Thank you. Let me move on to one of the other nominations that you're concerned with. Being from Montana, big sky country, you're concerned about the president's nominee for Secretary of Interior.
I do. So his nominee is Representative Deb Haaland, and she is a congresswoman from New Mexico. But she, like Becerra, has embraced the most far-left and radical ideas as it relates to her record on public lands and energy. Let me give you an example. She opposes all pipelines, not just the Keystone Pipeline, all pipelines. She wants a ban on fracking. She wants all fossil fuel infrastructure stopped. She opposes trapping on public land. She's opposed to everything that we need in the West to keep the lights on. She's opposed to it. She was ranked one of the top 10 most liberal members of the House. Now, Tony, that is a pretty distinguished list, because that would have AOC on that list. And really, she is embracing everything that AOC stands for. We've seen that, unfortunately, from Congresswoman Haaland.
Yeah, I was actually just listening to a speech she made back in 2018, the Netroots conference, in which she said exactly what you just said. She wants to eliminate all fossil fuels. She wants 100% dependence upon renewable energy. Ask the folks in Texas how that turned out last week.
It got a little chilly down there in Texas, didn't it? And I tell you, I hope the American people, the majority of American people, are seeing through this. I think they are, in terms of, you know, remember where we were, Tony, back in the 70s, dependencies on the Middle East.
Yeah.
When the Arab countries launched the attack, the War of Yom Kippur, oil prices quadrupled, and then those inflationary effects created interest rates of nearly 20% back in the early 80s. What that does to home ownership in terms of farms and ranches and business collapsing because of inflation, high interest rates. I mean, all that was tied to energy. And because of American energy innovation, we are now globally energy dominant. We're a net exporter now of energy. And these crazy far-left liberals now want to take us back to the dark ages.
You know, the only reason they can do that, Senator, is because of the success of the policies of the previous administration that gives us the luxury to be stupid.
I tell you, prosperity is causing us some problems right now. We're kind of spoiled on lower energy prices, a robust economy here before COVID. We got to keep up this fight here of common sense and balance.
Well, and I appreciate you doing that. I appreciate your very direct questioning in the committee today, and thank you for leading up the effort in the United States Senate on behalf of the sanctity of human life.
Thank you, Tony. God bless you and your efforts as well.
All right, Senator Steve Daines of Montana.